cast your burden upon
cast all your burdens upon the Lord,
and he will sustain you.
And he will sustain you. In the time of drought, he will never
permit
righteousness to be destroyed. Cast all your worries unto him. He will sustain you. Problems may come. Situations may come. Disturbances may come. These are part of the world. But the part of God that operates in you, it overcomes the things of this earth.
Amen.
The one who is in you is sufficient for you. Don't give up. Never give up. Refuse to be limited. Refuse to think that you are limited. No. Recently, Miss Peter was saying, Father, please pray. My account has come to very little. I don't have money. What shall we do? Please pray. I said, Sister, we'll pray. Our God will sustain us. Then within a week, she phoned to me and said, Father, what is needed for me for the whole year? The money is coming to the account. That is our God. Problems come. Situations come. Disturbances come. Things go wrong as they look. But don't be limited. If your life has to be renewed, be aware of the Lord. The God of glory is in you. He's with you. Hallelujah.
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 We read in the Gospel of Mark chapter 5 verse 28. There was a lady who was suffering for 12 years. The blood was blood hemorrhage. The blood was going on flowing. She was a rich woman, so she had money, but the Bible says she had spent all the money, and still she could not. But one fine day she realized God is with us in Jesus. So she said, if I may just touch his clothes, I shall be made whole. So she proceeded. Many things might have come against her. Hello, Jesus is never alone. He is with a crowd. How will you reach him? Hello, you are sick. You are not even able to walk. How are you going to run with the speed of Jesus and the people? Impossible. But she refused to be limited. She only started to think of Jesus. Start to think of Jesus. Jesus will come to you. This is the secret. Call upon me and I will answer you, and I will reveal to you things beyond your understanding. You can't understand. God will do for you. Jeremiah 33:3. What no eye has seen, what no ear has heard, what no one imagined, is the thing I will do for you. 1 Corinthians 2:9. Yes. You and I belong to that mighty God. So she proceeded. And the Bible says, Mark 5:29, the fountain of her blood was dried up. The moment she touched the garment of Jesus, and she felt in her body that she was healed of that plague. Jesus looked at her, 5:34, daughter, your faith has made you whole. Go in peace and be whole of that plague. Yes, that's why Jesus said, Mark 9:23, all things are possible to him who believes in Jesus, who is in you, who is with you, you have this great treasure. In this connection, be aware for God to renew you. Be aware of the Lord. Talk to Him. Talk to your situations with the Lord in you to get away from you. Talk to your sickness to get lost, for I have the Lord in me. And in the name of the Lord who is in me, I cast you out. Be aware of the Lord. One day, a king asked his ministers, I want to go and see all my kingdom, whether it is day or night. I want to walk and walk and walk. Within 20 days, I want to finish it up. Most of them said, Master, how is it possible? Because our land is full of mountains and valleys, and we don't have electricity. One minister said, wait, it's very simple. King, I will do it for you. How? When the king walks, let 4 people carry the Petromax light, 2 front, 2 back. Let the king be in the center, walk in the light. Wherever you go, light will be there. And the king put another condition, which is still difficult. He said, wherever I go, there may be thorns and thistles, so I need that the carpet should be put. I should walk on the carpet. Now, how to put the carpet? Everyone was scratching their head. The minister who prays, he said, very simple. King, give us your shoe. Inside the shoe, we will put nice carpet. Your leg will be always in the carpet. Yes. Be aware of the Lord who is with you, in you. And you walk in Him. Walk with Him. He will take care of you. Sickness will come. Problem will come. That's why Jesus said in Romans 16:20, I give you the power that you will step over the snakes and scorpions and go ahead. It is not God steps over snakes. He says, I give you the power because I am in you. So you will step over and live. So my dear friends, it is this realization, the truth that sets us free, that is God is in you. Celebrate that. And God is so kind to you, so merciful to you. So in your life journey, you find so many people might have hurt you, blamed you, even abused you. And now the Lord, without seeing who you are, what sinfulness has come into you, He has passed everything and He is staying in you. The same way, live out now that love in your life. Manifest that love. As Romans 5:8 says, God has loved us. While we are still sinners, He has loved us. He has made us His children. This is the love of God. Now hold on to that love. And let anybody think anything, anybody do anything, don't bother. See to it that what that comes from outside, do not take away the courage, the love, the faith God has given to you. Hold on to your God and hold on to what He gives to you. The inner courage to face anything, the inner peace that tells you God is in control of your life. And the courage that the Lord who is in you will turn everything into good in his time. So the renewal of life is you face the things that are coming against you with the truth that God is in you and he is with you. And all those who live by that truth, they never bow before the situation. Rather, they see as they walk, the situations bow before them. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.